this is Dr. VNSR Venkateswara. I am working as an associate professor in Department of Chemistry, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering, Hyderabad. So today I would like to give the topic on the question bank of water technology. So first of all, we see what are the contents involved in today's session. It involves the mainly three parts. Part A, nothing but short answer questions, weightage is 2 marks. And part B is nothing but long answer questions, weightage is 10 marks. And part C is nothing but problem solving and critical thinking questions, weightage is 10 marks. Okay. So first we see part A questions. Define hardness of the water. So hardness of the water is nothing but the sample of water which cannot give the leather with soap. Hardness of the water is defined as the sample of water which cannot be given leather with soap because of the salts of bicarbonates, salts of calcium and magnesium, and chlorates and sulfate salts of calcium and magnesium. So, for example, calcium bicarbonate or calcium chloride, magnesium bicarbonate, magnesium chloride, etc. All of these examples for hardness caused salts. So compare temporary and permanent hardness of the water. So temporary hardness is mainly caused by the bicarbonate salts of calcium and magnesium. That means temporary is mainly caused by calcium bicarbonate, and permanent is caused by the chlorates and sulfate salts of calcium and magnesium. That means calcium, chloride, calcium chloride. Okay, and what is the basic principle involved in the estimation of hardness of water by EDTA method? So that means it involves the complex metric method. That means when metal ion reacts with the EDTA to give metal EDTA complex. Okay, next one, define ppm and degree Clark. So ppm is nothing but it should be defined as the amount of the hardness expressed in terms of the calcium carbonate equivalence present in 10 power 6 parts. That means 1 million parts. So ppm is equal to 1 by 10 power 6. And degree Clark is defined as the amount of hardness expressed in terms of the calcium carbonate hardness it in the parts of the 1:70,000 parts. Okay, and define milligram per liter and degree French. So milligram per liter, that should be equal to 1 ppm. That means the amount of the hardness present in terms of calcium carbonate equivalence within the milligrams quantity of the salt present in 1 liter of the solution. And degree French. So degree French is nothing but it is the term of to determine amount of the hardness in terms of the calcium carbonate equivalence present in 10 power 5 parts nearby 1 lakh part. Okay, so what are the disadvantages of the hard water? So because of the usage of the hard water, what happens? Consumption of the fuel takes place in a cooking process, especially in domestic purpose. And in the case of the bathing purpose, consumption of the soap will be takes place. Compare the soft water and hard water. So soft water is nothing but the sample of the water which is readily to give the leather with soap, whereas hard water which is not readily to give the leather with soap. And what is soft water gives the examples of any two soft water resources. So soft water is nothing but it will be helpful to both domestic and industrial purpose. And the best example for a soft water is nothing but rain water. And how permanent hardness is removed from the hard water. So permanent hardness is removed from the hard water by using chemical treatment methods like ion exchange process and Gunn's permeated process and reverse osmosis. List the salts responsible for the temporary and permanent hardness of the water. So for temporary hardness, like magnesium bicarbonate salts, and for permanent hardness, like magnesium chloride and magnesium sulfate salts, etc. and temporary hardness is also caused by magnesium bicarbonate and calcium bicarbonate salts. And what is meant by treatment of the water? So treatment part of water is nothing but to remove the hardness causing salts from the sample of the water. So that is nothing but softening of the water. Define softening of the water. So softening of the water is also to remove the hardness causing salts like calcium bicarbonate, magnesium bicarbonate, calcium chloride and calcium sulfate. Magnesium chloride and magnesium sulfate, all these salts are removed from the sample of the water. So that is nothing but a softening of the water. The best example for a softening water is nothing but a ion exchange process. So how is natural water is sterilized by using the bleaching powder? So the basically bleaching powder formula is nothing but a calcium oxychloride. So because of the calcium oxychloride reacts with the water to give a hypochlorous acid. So that is hypochlorous acid can be acts as a disinfectant to kill that germs and bacteria present in the water. So this is nothing but a sterilization process. Explain breakpoint chlorination in treatment of the potable water. So first of all, breakpoint chlorination is nothing but the amount of the required chlorine to kill that pathogenic bacteria present in that water. So this can be explained by using the breakpoint chlorination. So after that, that water should be acts as a potable water and it should be applicable and useful for the domestic purpose. So explain reverse osmosis process to produce potable water. So reverse osmosis is nothing but the process of the flow of the solvent molecules from higher concentration to lower concentration when both are separated by a semi-permeable membrane. So then finally we got the water free from impurities, that means all the contaminants. So that is nothing but a reverse osmosis process. Finally you get a potable water. And what is the screening of the potable water? So screening of the potable water is nothing but when water flows through a large screens and it removes the like leaves and any other waste material. What are the advantages of a reverse osmosis? So reverse osmosis is removes the both reverse osmosis removes the both ionizable and non-ionizable particles. Even silica also removed by the reverse osmosis process. And what are the advantages and disadvantages of the ion exchange process? So advantages of ion exchange process is nothing but it removes both cationic impurities and anionic impurities. The disadvantages of the ion exchange process is nothing but it is a cost effective process. What is sedimentation? So sedimentation is nothing but when water is stored in a large storage tanks nearby 2 to 5 hours and the large solid particles like colloidal impurities are removed by the gravitational force and that impurity settle at the bottom of the tank. And what is potable water? So the sample of the water which is useful for the domestic purpose or human consumption, that is nothing but a potable water. So that is about the part A questions. Next we see part B questions. So explain the following. Why do we express the hardness of the water in terms of the calcium carbonate equivalent? Because the molecular weight of calcium carbonate should be equal to 100. And this calcium carbonate is most insoluble salt in water. Okay, and why hard water fails to produce a layer with soap solution? So that means in case of the hard water, it contains the salts of calcium, magnesium, bicarbonates and chlorates and sulfate salts. For example, if you can take as soap is nothing but the soaring salts of fatty acids, that means C17, H35, COONE. So this is nothing but sodium salts of fatty acids and it reacts with the hard water, nothing but calcium chloride to give C17, H35, COCA plus NaCl. So by balancing the chemical reaction, 2 moles of C17, H35, COONE reacts with the calcium chloride to give calcium stearate. So this is nothing but a white curdy precipitate and 2 moles of the NaCl. Because of the formation of this calcium stearate, it cannot give the leather with the soap. Distinguish between the hard water and the soft water. So hard water is nothing but the sample of the water which cannot give the leather with the soap. Soft water is nothing but the sample of the water which can give soap water is nothing but which can give leather with soap. And describe the experimental procedure for the determination of total hardness by EDTA method. So with the help of the EDTA method, we can determine the total hardness and permanent hardness and temporary hardness. So initially, we apply the process of the first process is nothing but a standardization of EDTA by standard zinc sulfate solution. So after the standardization of EDTA, it will be titrated against the with water sample. So by taking 100 ml of the water sample solution titrated with EDTA, finally it gives the color change wine red to blue in the presence of a buffer solution. So the initial reading gives the total hardness of the water. So after this process, the third step is nothing but a boiling of the water takes place. Because of the boiling process, the temporary hardness can be removed and the presence of only permanent hardness. That the sample of the boiled water again treated with the EDTA method, it gives the value of the molarity. That molarity gives the permanent hardness of the water. Finally, we calculate the temporary hardness is equal to temporary hardness is equal to total hardness, the second process, minus permanent hardness by third process. Finally, you got the three hardness: total hardness, permanent hardness, and temporary hardness. Okay, so this is the definition of a total hardness by EDTA method. And what is hardness of the water? Explain the terms of temporary and permanent hardness of a water. So that means hardness is nothing but the sample of the water which cannot give the leather with the soap. And it can be classified into mainly two types, temporary and permanent hardness. So temporary hardness is nothing but the salts of calcium and magnesium, especially the bicarbonate salts of calcium and magnesium causes the temporary hardness. And permanent hardness is nothing but chlorides, sulfates, salts of calcium. Define carbonate and non-carbonate hardness of the water. Write the various disadvantages of the hard water for domestic and industrial purpose. So carbonate hardness is nothing but a temporary hardness, and it is caused by the carbonate salts of calcium and magnesium. Non-carbonate hardness is nothing but a permanent hardness of the water, and it is caused by a chlorides and sulfate salts of calcium and magnesium. So by using this hard water, it can be consumption of a soap takes place in the bathing purpose, and consumption of fuel takes place in cooking purpose. And in case of the industrial purpose, so many byproducts are produced, we cannot maintain the pure concentration of a main product. So in an industrial purpose, especially boiler corrosion takes place. List is also responsible for the temporary hardness and permanent hardness. Explain the units of the hardness in which the hardness of the water is expressed. So, the temporary hardness is caused by calcium bicarbonate and magnesium bicarbonate. Permanent hardness is caused by calcium chloride magnesium chloride calcium sulfate magnesium sulfate. Okay, and the units of the hardness which is expressed in hardness of the water. So that is mainly there are four units: 1 ppm, 1 mg/L, 0.07 Clark degree, and it should be equal to 0.1 French degree. Okay. So what is the principle of a complex symmetric method? So the principle of the complex symmetric is nothing but the formation of a complex that is the chelating agent EDTA reacts with the metal ion to give metal EDTA complex. Finally, by using this complex symmetric method, generally the hardness causes also calcium, magnesium and metals nature because they are present in the second group of a periodic table. So these are called as alkali earth metals. So the metals having the tendency to form complex with EDTA. So finally observe the metal EDTA complex. Okay. So and from this we can determine the amount of the hardness present in the water. And explain the estimation of the hardness of the water by using complex symmetric method. So with the help of the complex symmetric method, we can determine both the total hardness. After that, the water should be boiled. Then we get the permanent hardness. Because of the boiling process, the temporary hardness can be eliminated. So at this stage, we have total hardness and permanent hardness. Because of the usage of this total hardness and permanent hardness, we can calculate further temporary hardness. What is hard water? Compare between temporary and permanent hardness of the water. So that means the hard water, because of the salts of calcium and magnesium, they cannot be useful for either domestic and industrial purpose. And temporary hardness is mainly caused by the bicarbonate salts of the calcium and magnesium, whereas permanent hardness is caused by the chlorates and sulfate salts of calcium and magnesium. Explain the basic principles involved in the estimation of the hardness of the water by ethylene diamine tetraesteric acid method. So mainly EDT is a chelating agent. It should be applicable for the complex symmetric method titration. So with the help of the volumetric titration principle, nothing but complex symmetric method, we can determine the amount of the hardness present in the water sample. What are the different units in which the hardness of the water is expressed? Explain their interconversion. So there are totally 4 units. PPM and milligram per liter and Clark degree and French degree, and the interconversion is nothing but 1 PPM is equal to 1 milligram per liter is equal to 0.07 Clark degree is equal to 0.1 French degree. Okay, so what are the requisites of the drinking water? Explain about coagulation and filtration treatment method of the potable water. So the main requisites of the drinking water is nothing but a pH should be 6.5 to 8.5 and TDS is nothing but less than 500 ppm and it should be colorless, odorless, and TO should be up to 5 ppm. Okay, so these are the main requisites of the drinking water. And by applying the coagulation process, nothing but ferrous alum or ferrous sulfate alum. So with respect to coagulation process, because of the coagulant impurities will be removed by the coagulation process. And in the filtration treatment, there are mainly 3 types of the layers: uniform gravel layer, sand layer, and with the help of these 3 layers, the filtration takes place and you get the pure water. And what is sterilization of the water? How is natural water is sterilized by the chlorine, bleaching powder and the chloramines? So generally sterilization of water is nothing but the process of to remove or killing the pathogenic bacteria. So that is nothing but sterilization of the water. So because of the bleaching powder, calcium oxychloride to give a hypochlorous acid when it reacts with the water. That hypochlorous acid can act as a disinfectant to kill that pathogenic bacteria. And even some chloramines also produced that can be removed by the breakpoint chlorination. So what is potable water? Explain how sterilization of the water is carried out by using chlorine and ozone. So potable water is nothing but the sample of the water which is useful for a domestic purpose or human consumption. So that is nothing but a potable water. And in the case of the sterilization process by using hypochlorous acid to remove pathogenic bacteria. In case of ozone, what happens? The nascent oxygen, whenever the ozone dissociates to give oxygen and individual oxygen. So that individual oxygen is nothing but a nascent oxygen. So this nascent oxygen can act as a disinfectant. What are the ion exchange regions? Describe their application in water softening method. So there are totally ion exchange regions are two types. One is cation exchange regions and center one is the anion exchange regions. So first of all, these regions having the capability to exchange the ions with respect to their cation exchange regions and anion exchange regions. In case of the cation exchange regions, the H plus ions are having ability to exchange the impurities caused by the cationic hardness like calcium, magnesium. In anion exchange regions, the attachments replace the anionic hardness caused from the hardness like chlorides and sulfates. And in the case of the water softening method, we use the ion exchange process. What are the specifications of the potable water? Explain breakpoint chlorination of the water. So specifications of the water, we should already explain in the previous slide. So that is nothing but pH 6.5 to 8.5 and TDS is less than 500 ppm. And it should be colorless, odorless. And DO, that means dissolved oxygen up to 5 ppm. And in the case of the breakpoint chlorination, that means the requirement of the oxygen to remove that complete pathogenic bacteria. So that is the breakpoint chlorination. Explain the desalination of the water by reverse osmosis method. So first of all, desalination is nothing but the removal of salt, nothing but common salt from the sample of the water. So that is nothing but a desalination process. And by applying reverse osmosis method, what happens? The process of flow of the water from higher concentration to lower concentration, then both are separated by a semipermeable membrane. So that means higher concentration means the water present in high contamination side and it can be separated out to the lower concentration, that means pure water, and both are separated by semipermeable membrane. And this reverse osmosis is applicable for the not only ionic impurities, even it is applicable to non-ionic impurities, and even silica also removed by the reverse osmosis process. Describe the demineralization process of the softening of the hard water and write its advantages. So demineralization means the sample of the water should be free from all the dissolved salts. That is nothing but a demineralization process. And the advantages of the ion exchange process is nothing but it can remove both cationic impurities and anionic impurities. And hardness is nothing but to get 0 to 2 ppm. And that sample of water is should be applicable for the boilers in the case of the industries. What is the principle of the reverse osmosis? Explain the how seawater is purified by using this technique. So the main principle involved in the reverse osmosis is nothing but the process of the flow of the solvent molecules from higher concentration to lower concentration when both are separated by a semipermeable membrane. So because of this reverse osmosis process, even the it can be removed by both ionic and non-ionic impurities and even silica and salt content, especially present in higher concentrations. That's why it should be applicable to remove the impurities from the seawater also. Even by using reverse osmosis, even seawater is also softening takes place. What is external treatment of the water? Explain any one method with a knee diagram and write its advantages and disadvantages. So external treatment of the water is nothing but the softening of the water takes place before entering into the boilers. So by using ion exchange process or reverse osmosis process, we can remove the sample of the water. So that means, for example, if we can take as a ion exchange process, first we see log diagram, source of the water, then it enters into a cation exchanges. After it will be entering to anion exchange. Finally, to get pure water. Okay, and the advantages of this ion exchange process is nothing but to get hardness of the water up to 0 to 2 ppm. And it can remove both cationic and anionic impurities. And the disadvantage is nothing but the cost of process is high. Okay, so this is about the advantages and disadvantages of the external treatment of the water by using ion exchange process. So now we see the part C questions, which is also 10 marks. So first we see, why do we add buffer solution during the estimation of hardness of the water by EDTA method? So because of the EDTA method, it is very, very important to maintain the stable complex. That means metal with EDTA complex. Metal with the EDTA complex. So for the purpose, we maintain the pH 10. So for the maintenance of the pH 10, we use the basic buffer solution. Basic buffer. So basic buffer is the combination of a ammonium chloride with ammonia. That means we see 142 ml of the ammonia with 17.3 grams of the ammonium chloride substance, and make up to 250 ml volumetric flask. So because of the this buffer solution, in order to maintain the pH 10, it should be formed stable complex like zinc with EDTA or calcium with EDTA complex and magnesium with EDTA complex. Either any one of the metal you consider. Okay, and the color change takes place from wine red to blue. So these two processes takes place if and only if in the presence of a buffer solution, and the buffer of that pH should be equal to pH 10. So that means the buffer is nothing but a, in order to maintain the constant pH of the solution, either by addition of either acid or alkali solutions. So so what happens when temporary hard water is boiled give reactions? So for example, temporary hardness is mainly caused by the salts of calcium and bicarbonate. So that means when calcium bicarbonate is heating takes place, it gives the calcium carbonate, that means precipitate and water and carbon dioxide. So this carbon dioxide should be evaporated because of the gas, and calcium carbonate precipitate is can be removed by the filtration process and finally get a pure water. And the third one, 1 liter of the water sample collected from the a water source in Telangana has the following analysis: magnesium bicarbonate 14.6 milligrams, magnesium sulfate 12 milligrams, calcium bicarbonate 16.2 milligrams, calcium chloride 22.2 milligrams, magnesium chloride 9.5 milligrams, and organic impurities of 100 milligrams. So calculate temporary and permanent hardness in degree in the fridge. So first of all, we see temporary hardness is mainly caused by the magnesium bicarbonate salts. And calcium bicarbonate salts. Okay, next, permanent hardness is mainly caused by the magnesium sulfate and calcium chloride and magnesium chloride. And organic impurities should not involve the any hardness of the water. So that means we calculate only temporary and permanent hardness in degree in French. So with the help of the expression of the hardness in terms of the calcium carbonate equivalence, expression of the hardness in terms of calcium carbonate equivalence, so that should be equal to weight of the salt by molecular weight of the salt into 100. So by using this formula, we can calculate these salts, that means both the temporary hardness causes salts and the permanent hardness causes salts, into the expression of the hardness in terms of the calcium carbonate equivalence. Finally, you get a temporary and permanent hardness in ppm mole, and that can be converted into degree in French. So because of the, by using this calcium carbonate hardness, we get a hardness in ppm mole, that means 1 ppm is equal to degree in French. So degree in French should be equal to 0.1 French degree. So this is the conversion when we get the hardness in ppm mole or milligram per liter mole. So finally you got temporary hardness in 20 ppm, and that can be converted into degree in French. You got 2 degree in French, and permanent hardness nearby 40 ppm, and we got 4 French degree. Okay, next we see the fourth problem. 1 liter of the water from an underground reservoir in Tirupati town in Andhra Pradesh showed the following analysis for its content: magnesium bicarbonate 42 milligrams, calcium bicarbonate 146 milligrams, calcium chloride 71 milligrams, magnesium sulfate 48 milligrams. Calculate temporary, permanent and total hardness of the sample after 10,000 liters of the water sample. So first of all, we see these magnesium bicarbonate and calcium bicarbonate causes the temporary hardness of the water, and calcium chloride and magnesium sulfate causes the permanent hardness of the water. So by the combination of temporary plus permanent to give a total hardness of the water. Okay, so and this can be calculated expression of the hardness in terms of the calcium carbonate. We see formula. So that is weight of the salt by molecular weight of the salt into 100. And finally, we got temporary hardness for 10,000 liters of the water. ppm. And permanent hardness should be equal to 10,39,600 ppm, and total hardness should be equal to 22,28,400 ppm. Okay, so this is the solution for a given problem. Next, problem 5. A sample of the hard water contains the following dissolved salts per liter: magnesium bicarbonate 14.6 milligrams, calcium bicarbonate 16.2 milligrams, calcium chloride 111 milligrams, calcium sulfate 1.36 milligrams, silica 40 milligrams, and turbidity 10 milligrams. So calculate the temporary, permanent, and total hardness of the water in ppm, degree Clark, and degree French. So that means we got the temporary hardness because of the salts of magnesium bicarbonate and calcium bicarbonate, and permanent hardness is mainly caused by the calcium chloride and calcium sulfate, and with the help of the silica and turbidity, there is no involvement of the hardness of the water. That's why you should not consider the silica and turbidity. Okay, now you can calculate the hardness of the water with the help of the previous slide formula. So that is nothing but expression of the hardness in terms of the calcium carbonate equivalence. That should be equal to weight of the salt by molecular weight of the salt into 100. Finally, we got temporary hardness temporary hardness 20 ppm, and permanent hardness 101 ppm, and total hardness becomes 121 ppm. So and it should be converted into degree Clark. So degree Clark is nothing but 2 multiplied by 0.07. that means 1 ppm is equal to 0.07 Clark degree, and that should be equal to 1 ppm is equal to 0.1 French degree. Okay. That means in Clark degree, you got 1.4 Clark degree for temporary hardness. For permanent hardness, you got 7.07 Clark degree. And for total hardness, you got 8.47 Clark degree. Okay, and in French degree, you got 0.2 French degree. And in the case of the permanent hardness, you got 10.1 French degree. And in the case of the total hardness, you got 12.1 French degree. Okay, so this is the solution for the given problem. And sixth one, calculate temporary and permanent hardness of the water sample which contains 6.8 milligrams of the calcium sulfate, 33 milligrams of the calcium chloride, 40 milligrams of the magnesium chloride, 24 milligrams of the magnesium sulfate per liter of the water sample. And they give the molar masses of calcium is equal to 40 milligrams, magnesium 24 milligrams, sulfur is equal to 32 grams, oxygen is equal to 16 grams, chlorine is equal to 35 grams. So they want to calculate temporary and permanent hardness. So temporary hardness is mainly caused by the, there is no salts causes the temporary hardness according to given problem. So there is no temporary hardness. That means temporary hardness should be equal to 0 ppm. But permanent hardness is mainly caused by the, there are calcium sulfate and calcium chloride and magnesium chloride and magnesium sulfate. So, and the in each and individual salt can be converted into the expression of the hardness in terms of the calcium carbonate by using the formula weight of the salt by molecular weight of the salt into 100. Finally, we got permanent hardness. Permanent hardness should be equal to 96.82 ppm. Okay, and the next one, a sample of the water of 100 ml required 12.6 ml of the 0.02 molar EDTA solution with EBT as indicator and 8.4 ml of the 0.02 molar EDTA for the same volume of the water after removing carbonate hardness. Calculate total permanent hardness in terms of calcium carbonate equivalents. So that means we see initially 100 ml of the water required for 12.6 ml of the 0.02 molar EDTA solution. So based on by using the formula M1V1 is equal to M2V2, we got total hardness molarity. So that should be equal to M1 is equal to 0.00252, and from the molarity of the M1 we got total hardness. That should be equal to 252 ppm. Okay, and secondly, they give the 8.4 ml of the 0.02 molar EDTA for the same volume of the water after removing the carbonate hardness. That means removing carbonate hardness means boiling water takes place. Temporary hardness will be eliminated. Remaining is permanent hardness. So that should be calculated by using the formula M2V2 is equal to M3V3. So we got M3, that is permanent hardness molarity, we got 0.00168 molar. From this molarity, we got permanent hardness, that should be equal to 168 ppm. Okay, so this is the solution for the problem number 7. And problem number 8, a sample of the water 20 ml required 18.2 ml of 0.01 molar EDTA solution with EBT as indicator and 4.6 ml of the 0.01 molar EDTA for the same volume of the water after removing the carbonate hardness. Calculate total permanent hardness in terms of the calcium carbonate equivalents. So that means we got by using the previous formula, M1 gives the total hardness and M3 gives the permanent hardness. So total hardness should be equal to 910 ppm and permanent hardness equal to 230 ppm. Okay, this is the solution for problem number 8 and problem number 9. So a sample of the water of 20 ml required for 22.5 ml of 0.02 molar EDTA solution with EVT as indicator and 14.5 ml of 0.02 molar EDTA for the same volume of the water after removing the carbonate hardness. Calculate total permanent hardness in terms of the calcium carbonate equivalence. So again, we calculate the total hardness by using the formula M1 for total hardness and M3 for permanent hardness. So finally, we got total hardness for the ninth problem. That should be equal to 2250 ppm. And permanent hardness. That should be equal to 1450 ppm. Okay, so this is the solution for problem number 9. And the last question, what is the main advantage of the reverse osmosis process over ion exchange process? So by using ion exchange process, we can remove the both cationic and anionic impurities. That means the impurities present in the ionized form. And with the help of the ion exchange process, we cannot remove the non-ionized impurities. But by using the reverse osmosis process, we can remove both ionic impurities and non-ionic impurities. Even silica and turbidity is also removed by the reverse osmosis process. So that are the advantages of a reverse osmosis compared to a ion exchange process. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.